Hello there, and welcome to episode 7 of The Rise of Vowles, a Williams story, with me, Darth Ravon Gaming. We have a new driver, the Honey Badger returns. He comes with some self-inflicted money troubles, where we are going to need to basically not wreck anything, and come away with some seriously decent returns on the racing front. So,
welcome along to Italy, and welcome along to Imola.
We have rain, and lots of it. This actually might be to our benefit. So, was I putting new parts in the car at all? What I might do is put the old chassis on car one, on car two rather, just for now. So underfloor wise, we've just got the one new underfloor, just because I really don't want to wreck it and I want Danny Rick to get used to the car. So I genuinely don't know what to do with Imola. We definitely want to throw all the camber on, without a doubt. Let's give them... Is it not raining straight away? It's not raining straight away. Let's just have a look at the circuit info. So...
Doggo! Be quiet.
So it looks as though we're going to want to save some medium tyres, really. Imola's a very long pit lane, though. I would expect we're going to want some oversteer balance around here. Let's try that. 6 and 12. I wonder if we're going to. It's a more downforce actually. Gives us some extra braking stability. Traction's not so important around here, if I remember right. Let's try that. We'll give that a go. And I think leaving the toe angle is probably the way to go as well, just to start with. But I reckon You know what? I'm just going to throw all the toe angle on Donny Rick. Let's do a pre-session save, just in case things go horribly wrong with the game again. And it crashes, like it always seems to be doing. And I think we'll start with softs. Get some laps on the board. So we're going to be using, at the very least, inters midway through the session. So 49.22 for the powertrain for Danny Rick and 49.28. Well, considering that he's only just got in the car, I would say 2/10 away from Albon, 3/10 away from Albon.
Okay.
Is perfectly acceptable. Please tell me he's not hit one of our cars. Good, good. He did not hit one of our cars. I would say timing wise, this
BSC ending
looks pretty good for us coming in.
I think the rain's coming down.
And you know what? Albon with a top 10 time, I am okay with. Especially with his engine in that sort of condition. Where is he? I think we'll pull him in next lap. I think that's reasonable.
And car balance feedback when capacity?
Yep, good.
Yep, copy. There's a risk of rain coming.
Yep. Daniel Pillow.
What's not quite like? On pit exit. On max. Engine off.
Okay, so we need more traction. We got good oversteer balance. This is pretty good. I reckon that might be it for Albon. Now the question is, how wet's it getting? Might try that. It's going to be close. I may cross-reference each other's setups. Seven, 12.5, 3.7. Right, let's send them and see what happens. So the lap times are all very similar. Very similar indeed. Technically, Donny Rick's in a worse car. Would you be quiet?
Back on balance.
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
Okay.
Okay. So it is literally just a braking stability change we need on Albono. So we'll just throw 15 laps of fuel in and send him back out. Whereas with Danny Rick, it's a little bit more severe. What I think we'll do is throw a tiny bit less wing on and send him straight back out. So even with that slightly compromised setup, Danny Rick was quicker over the course of a stint. And he's lighter on his tyres. Driver prep is 80%. That's mad. So, moderate rain for session two. Let's see where we're at with this. So that's still great. So we need to send him back out with that. I feel like a medium set for both cars. 20 laps of fuel and hope for the best. Let's just double check the session overview. It's no rain to start. So medium tyres it is. So we are 0.8 back on a set of mediums versus Sonoda on softs. And there doesn't appear to be much of a drop off on the softs either versus the meds. Much of a drop off at all, in fact. I feel like Danny Rick might be wanting to use two sets of softs in the race. Oh, there's Sonoda's drop off. Where is he on the track? He's not on track. Where's the rain? Coming now, basically. Did I not change Albon's setup? Oh, for God's sake. Rain is very light.
Okay, there's a big crash. Be careful for debris.
Let's see, multiple cars apparently. Well, two. Is that De Vries again? It's De Vries again. That's got to be Ocon at fault though.
What the f was that, honestly?
It was you sticking your car up the inside of somewhere where it didn't belong, mate. Is what that was. The fact that we are at a power circuit and we're putting times in that are
close on the Delta.
Yeah, okay.
Where they are, that's acceptable.
VLC is ending.
Yep.
We are, however, struggling on tyre temps. Johnny, get your five in.
Feedback on track.
Oh, yes. That'll do. Right. Intermediate tyres, back out you go. We are looking at now. Major issues with wear for the engine in Danny Rick's car, which is a bit of a problem. So driver prep is good. And Danny Rick's times are consistently better than Magnussen's.
On the way around.
It's not going to stay dry. Hovering around the crossover. Both cars doing very similar lap times. Great news.
Yeah, copy that.
Let's drop the fuel use down on both cars. Albon's got to come in. Danny Rick does not need to.
Okay, let's check a flag.
This is very acceptable. What I might do now is throw that new chassis in. And see what sort of difference it's going to make for him. What underfloor? What are we using? We're using underfloor part 2. Okay, that's fine. Quick pre-session save. So using up the harder tyres because we don't need them for the race. Desperately don't want to be losing out on softs, so off we go. When's the rain? Soon, very soon. Fantastic.
The rain's coming down. Okay.
The rain's coming down fast.
Further rain expected. Copy.
So watch out for track.
Okay. Now it's just a case of don't wreck the car. That rain's going away and going away fast. Stopping.
Now this, I think, was at turn 13. Oh, and they need to be watching those tracks.
Could have gone worse. So Albon's just putting his tyres back in. Donny Rick's times are definitely better. Especially given the engine situation.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
And yes, we have. We've had a crash.
Please don't have wrecked the chassis.
Let's see what happened there. Now, this was the seventh corner. Dangerously close to each other.
Seems to be no damage. Why has he been given a pen?
Feedback from you. I'm happy. Yep.
Right, so basically now we really need to push Donny Rick on the grid. Okay, so Albono is basically at 100% for his parts, and how is he only on driver prep 59%? That doesn't make any sense. I'm not going to send any more cars out. I don't see the point. We've done our run plans. Would you be quiet? Oi! 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 No. So, end of the session. Aside from Donny Rick picking up a grid penalty, I would call that a decent day. So we got some good confidence for both drivers.
Welcome everyone to qualifying.
And a rainy quali. Heavy rain for quali. And we're guaranteeing a 15th place or higher. And I think we don't need to really worry about that. So 1.58 mil of track water, I think going out early is going to be the way to go. Supposedly, Danny Rick uses less fuel. I'm guessing this is due to the decreased weight on the chassis. But let's find out. Manual control, please, on both cars.
Okay, understood.
Happy to increase pace.
Yes.
We're happy to push.
Okay.
Let's reduce. Lifting coast.
Copy.
Let's try and get these brakes fired up again.
Okay, copy.
If you've got any pace left, it would be good now.
Okay.
You can increase the pace.
Understood.
And we think you can reduce lifting coast.
Copy.
Like to reduce slight cut.
Understood.
Can use the overtake.
Yeah, copy.
I have a great fear of catching these cars. May as well bring him in. They done It's all going to be relative to what goes on with the weather now. And we are going to have to use some softs. Which the game will not allow us to use. Track water level is dropping. Why is he on inters?
Track is full.
Yeah.
He's gonna have to absolutely shift. He made it to the line.
Checkered flag. Checkered flag.
Thank you. Can he make it? This is going to be problematic. Come on, Danny Rick. There you go. So we're on heavy rain, which is fine. I'm okay with those tire settings. So the rain is going to decrease with the session. I feel it is worth sending the cars out. On inters. Would have been better sending them out on inters.
Alexa, go switch out.
Yeah, copy.
Keep the pace up.
Copy.
Can you bring the pace up, please?
Okay, understood.
These guys are all going to be in our way. With a bit of luck, Albon's going to be around Tsunoda there, and then Ricciardo will get round him before the hairpin. It's not before the hairpin. Norris is getting in someone's way here. Hopefully he'll move out of the way, but I'm not seeing it. Definitely moved out of the way of Albon. Has he moved out of the way of Danny Rick? Yes. Why have they come in? Oh, I've done it again. Well, the good news is they're at peak confidence. It's probably worth sending the guys out straight away. Thank you. I really need Albon to be round Gasly quick. There we go. Albon's slow, Danny Rick's quick. Why is Albon slow? So Albon's lap wasn't great. Are these boys getting back in time? I'm very worried about their fuel situation. Yeah, they're okay. I'll be amazed if Danny Rick doesn't make it through. Albon might struggle. We could be looking at a Q3 for one car here, I think. Yeah. Albon's sector one time was far too slow. And that's fine. So we've achieved all of those. We're not going to get fastest lap, not unless we throw soft tyres on at the end, do medium, medium, soft. Which is what we're going to have to do. Okay. So Danny Rick is on 4. We have 2 softs available. Or do we? Because is it not raining? It's cloudy. If we're going to go, we have to go fast.
Is there?
Yep.
You can increase the pace.
Yep.
Now you don't do call-in. We're going to leave the same tyres on. Less fuel. Rain's supposed to be coming now. The rain is now. Another lap doesn't matter. We've got P5 with a grid pen. I'll take that. I'm happy with that. That is a satisfactory qualifying session. Who else has grid pens? Just Nick DeVries. Fantastic. So we are aiming at climbing. Wow, how is Yuki at P10? AlphaTauri must have had some hefty upgrades. Having said that, they're a second back. Okay. We need to do some sponsor payouts here. So we've made $500,000. Not made any money there. We can make $1 million here easy. But we need to do position gains. I think we aim for points for Albon. And I think P7 is kind of... I don't think I want to push it for P6. It's a 200,000 gain, but like, I'm not doing it. Okay. It's not meant to rain, so... Strat 1 is 122.05. Soft medium, mediums are 122.08. But if we do medium push, right, return strat list, delete this strat. Strat B then becomes a soft medium. Soft is not an option. Or is it? A medium soft is, however, an option. So the hard, yeah, okay, so medium soft is the way to go here. if we select that and just do a medium soft medium as an option. We'll do the same with Albon. Just some of interest. That's very interesting. Push on the hards is quicker. That's mad. Okay. So let's look at a medium hard soft. That's a very interesting strategy. I think strat D. Maybe a kingpin strat here. Slap 22, lap 46. The thing is, going with hards on stint 2 will mean a safety car will be a problem. If it does save us 10 seconds. I think we start with strat A and we look at the tyre wear. Not strat A. Strat A gets deleted from Albon. We don't use that. We're going to use strat A, and then if we want to swap, we can. I think we need to not start with extra fuel. I think that is the way. And then we'll go from there. Okay. Let's go. Imola.
Here in Imola, the drivers are ready to take on the 63 laps. Of the Emilia Romagna.
Is that an Aston Martin on pole?
You and I won't be the only ones keeping an eye on Oscar Piastri, Carew.
What can they manage from 18?
This is it. The Emilia Romagna.
That is Stroll on pole.
And it's lights out, and away we go.
Okay, so we need, first and foremost, ERS battle assist and overtakes. We're going for maximum pace here. Full overtake aggression.
Okay.
Minimum defense aggression. Hamilton on the softs is a problem. But he's a problem we may as well just let go. that Alfa Romeo and the McLaren should be an easy dispatch. What we'll do is, we'll have to have it on deploy here to try and get around. The Alfa Romeo seems very quick in a straight line. The important thing is we're dropping Tsunoda and we're sticking with Hamilton. Somebody went. Who went? LeGreg. Stroll. Okay. Right, let's not use deploy there for, either driver, actually.
GRS enabled.
Time to push, Danny Rick. Time to push.
Aggressive with overtake usage.
Understood. Nice. Nice driving. P11.
Okay, so
close the gap if you can.
Need Danny Rick to catch up a little bit here. So that's Albon up to P9. I think Danny Rick has managed to get Ocon here. Has Hamilton's tyres started to go off? That's the question.
Crash turn 7, tyre wall. Be careful for debris.
Who crashed? Gasly. Danny Rick needs to turn the light back up. Ocon needs, not Ocon. Okay, we've lost DRS, which is a bit of an issue. Right, Albon needs to cool his tyres. So, not really losing ground to Ocon. Albon is sticking with Norris for now. Turn the wick back up for Albon, I think, and have another go. And what we'll do with Danny Rick is we'll stay off the high risk curbs as well, and see where that gives us for tyre temps. Not good is what it gives us actually. Let's remove the high-risk curb issue and go back to drop the tyre temps. That was a better option. And we'll just do a top up on the RS now for Albon. So Ocon's coming back into play. Let's just turn the tyre weight back up for Danny Rick. What's the pit lane concern here? Twenty-six seconds. We're looking at coming out quite late on. Like P18. We need to clear that battle. I don't think we can. I mean, we are doing 1 second a lap quicker. Right, Albon can remove the high risk curb issue now. And go back to neutral, because he's otherwise going to cause problems. Why is Alonso so low down? I do think we need to look at strat B as the option here, or strat C, more the point. I think that is going to be our better option.
Aggressive with the overtake usage.
Okay. Okay, press and hold overtake. Okay. You can afford to drop back.
Yep.
Box.
Box confirmed.
Both cars have quite a nice gap to drop into there as well. Hamilton's pitting to cover off Ricciardo. How much of an undercut are we talking here? We're not. Is the short of it. So we'll go to around negative 0.7 on these tyres, I think. Really abuse them. Maybe negative 0.6. And then bring the pace back. So we need to go to aggressive overtakes now. No defending. This is going to be where it gets interesting, is where Perez and Sainz come out. I think we need to do a lap of cooldown. Can't quite work out why Albon was so slow that last lap. We can now drop the tyre temps back to the full push. And I'm just beginning to wonder if it might be quicker to go on to the mediums. Gives a new strat. The simple answer is yes. Apparently 4 seconds quicker to hard push the mediums. Um, We'll see where we are. Fact is, we've almost made up a pit stop on Russell and Gasly. Albon's got to push. Otherwise, he's going to lose time here. Let's get one of those Alpha Tauris and then get the other one. That'll do. Right. Would you be quiet? So that's Donny Rick approaching. On this train of cars here. Roxy, shush. We can drop the pace here. We're gonna go, we gotta go now. Three wide, Danny Rick has not done the job. Drop the pace. Why haven't you got around that Alpine? Come on, buddy. That's an Alpine on dead tyres. How are you not skinning him? That heavily compromised us. So Albon's just chilling. We seem to not be gaining fuel back at the rate that I was kind of hoping either, which is a bit of a problem. So science has now dropped out of DRS, so in theory, when did science pit? Science didn't pit. So as it stands, we are lapping faster than everyone but Le Greg and Ocon. We are potentially going to come out of the pit somewhere in the region of around P10. Albon is lapping a second quicker than everyone but Gasly. So we're basically on for a bit of a lonely day now. Yeah, we know. Until Ocon catches up with us, and then we can use him for DRS, but I don't think he's going to catch up with us fast enough. Ocon posting a fastest lap just now is not what I want to see. Let's go back out of this. We don't want to have excessive overtakes and we don't want to do DRS battle assist. We literally want to sit in with him. Would you be quiet? No, none of that. Okay, so Le Greg's gone to fastest lap now. How many seconds back are we talking here? We are still lapping quicker than Albon, not quicker than everybody else. We'll drop in just behind Russell, I think. Roxy, would you be quiet? Ricciardo's in. Albon in. So Ricciardo comes out in front of Russell, which is a massive deal. Why can Ricciardo not break Russell is my concern. Oh no, 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 no. The lack of braking Russell is an issue. We basically need to catch Russell and then do a fastest lap. That's the shit. That'll do. Right, Albono's done Hulkenberg. We did that off camera. In all seriousness though, can we actually catch Alonso? Because I don't think we can. How is Alonso doing 16.9s?
Starting time management.
Understood. Okay, happy to manage tyre short term. Let's go push. Okay, Alex, we can start reducing lift and coast.
Great. We know the fastest lap for us then. Tony Rick is going to need to go on a fuel save, I think. Albon is right up the back of that Red Bull.
So this is what happened. Now this one involves Stroll. Things were all right here. And the car just locks.
Oh dear, Lance. Right, we are now in a fuel saving position. Let's do harvest rather than fuel save. Where's Alonso's tyres at? 47. Do a lap of harvest, then a lap of fuel save, and then a push lap to take him. Save the fuel, mate. Save the fuel.
fluid, so be mindful of that.
Look after your tyres.
Okay, understood.
Time to go, Danny Rick. He hasn't got him. Round the outside.
Has crossed the line first.
Okay, that's
great stuff, Danny Rick. Great stuff. So we didn't get the fastest lap, but we were close. It was really close. So Danny Rick pulls himself straight to P12 in the Drivers' Championship. And we do not stick with Alpine, unfortunately. Nothing for us in here, I'm afraid. Still quite a long way off with that, to be honest. We've had a successful day, I would say. What do you mean race DNF? P11. 4 million, we are back in the black. New chassis complete. Problems with the cars though. Something has failed. A front wing. Okay, so what were we developing? We're developing a rear wing and a chassis at the moment. But I think we need to make a sub. Oh. We are going to need to make a side pod. Because we're not developing one. Who is this Clement Novak? I'm not interested in him.
Silly doggo, be quiet.
It's got a new underfloor coming. We did develop a new part, and I don't remember which one it was. A suspension. It can be ready in... time for Monaco? Do we rush it? I think we do. I do think we rush it. I think we give ourselves an opportunity in Monaco. And I think we do need to look at a front wing. Or two. Now, as far as research and development's concerned, we do need to look at something else. That stuff's available in 10 days. None of it's going to be ready before Montreal. So I think we go 11 days there. And 11 days there, giving us 3 more engineers for a new part. And I just feel like an engineer for side pod is the way to go. Let's go cooling and airflow. I think what we'll probably do is install the original suspensions for practice. Wear them out. And go from there. Okay. Thanks for watching. Till next time. Don't forget to follow, subscribe, like, and all that for more doggo noises and things. Cheers.